in the last class we derived Bernoulli equation and Euler equation also. Now I am going to give you shortcut technique to derive Bernoulli equation, derivation of Bernoulli equation, derivation of Bernoulli equation from the conservation of energy, from the conservation of energy concept. Okay, this is shortcut method, but in examination if you are told to derive the relation Bernoulli equation, then do not follow this. You have to start from basic principle that we have derived Euler equation. If you integrate Euler equation, you will get Bernoulli equation. But this is for short technique and this is for numerical problem. Okay, that is based on the conservation of energy, that energy is neither created nor be destroyed. Okay, based on that I am going to derive this concept. This is shortcut. Okay, this is shortcut technique, section 11, this is section 22. Okay, flow is along this line. So let P1, V1 and Z1 be the pressure head, kinetic head and datum head at the entry section, or we can call it as section 11. That is at section 11. That is pressure energy is P1, then V1, then Z1. Similarly, P2, V2 and Z2 be the same properties at exit or at section 22. Okay, so that, see this one Z1 and this is Z2. Okay, now see, area is reducing here, that is diameter is less, that is from A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Okay, so here area is reducing, from area A1, A2 is less here. Okay, A2 is less, so velocity will increase. So increase kinetic energy will increase. Okay, so increase in kinetic energy, because area is less, so velocity will be more. So increase, that will be equal to V² / 2g minus V1² / 2g. How much energy, kinetic energy is increasing, that is V2² / 2g minus V1² / 2g. Okay, that is increase in kinetic energy. Another, elevation also, see, that's it, increase in datum energy also, that will be Z2 minus Z1. Okay, Z2 minus Z1. So that is our this one. Now from the principle of conservation of energy, pressure energy has to reduce. Why? Because two energies are increasing, this is increasing, this is also increasing, so pressure energy has to reduce. So that is P1 / gamma minus P2 by gamma will be equal to, see pressure energy is reducing, decreasing, will be equal to sum of this one, that one, V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G plus Z2 minus Z1. Okay, see this one, what is derivation of Bernoulli equation from the conservation of energy concept. Okay, that means here since area is reducing, so kinetic energy increasing. So increase in kinetic energy is V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. Either see elevation is also increasing, so increase in datum energy, that is Z2 minus Z1, that will be elevation, increase in elevation also. Since two energies are increasing, another third form of energy, that is pressure energy, has to reduce from the concept of energy conservation principle. Okay, energy is neither created nor be destroyed. Okay, total energy this much will be equal to here also same. So from the principle of conservation of energy, pressure energy has to reduce. Now see here, P1 by gamma plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 will be equal to P2 by gamma plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. That means energy at section 1 1 will be energy at section 2 2. This is energy at section 1 1 will be equal to energy at section 2 2. So this energy remains constant. Okay, so we can call it as P by gamma plus V square by 2G plus Z is equal to constant. This is what? Your Bernoulli equation. Okay, so this concept is also very useful in solving the numerical, but when you are asked to derive the Bernoulli equation, you have to start from the very basic principle, that is from Euler equation, flow is along the streamline, and pressure force, gravity force, considering weight of the fluid only, and there you are getting Euler equation. If you integrate that Euler equation, you will get the Bernoulli equation. Okay, that derivation is very useful, and you have to write derivation that method only. This method is shortcut, see, and nothing wrong here also. That is the derivation I have derived from the conservation of energy principle. Energy at section 1-1 will be energy at section 2-2. This is the statement, and that we have proved in this way. Let the energy at section 1-1 is P1, V1, Z1 be the pressure energy, kinetic energy, and datum energy or datum head also at entry section. Similarly, this one at exit section. Increase in kinetic energy is V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. Increase in datum energy is Z2 minus Z1. So, by the principle of conservation of energy, two energies are increasing. That means third energy has to reduce. So, third energy is our pressure energy has to reduce. So, P1 by gamma minus P2 by gamma will be equal to this kinetic energy and datum energy. So, we are getting P by gamma plus V square by 2G plus Z is constant. Okay. And rest of the application of Bernoulli equation like orifice meter, venturi meter, pitot tube, that I will discuss in next class. Thank you.